My name is Jennifer, and I'm addicted to eating mattresses. I like my mattress plain and straight up. I know mayonnaise, butter, none of that.
There's like a hard texture, like my taste buds, it'll, you know, kind of like a guitar.
When I found out that Jennifer eats mattresses, I was just bum-founded. I was like, oh, it blew my mind that she did that.
I make sure, like, when my mom's not gonna be in her room, where I can be in her room. So, like, let's say when she get in the shower, tiptoeing in here to get it. Well, the reason why I'm not eating my own mattress is because I ate my mattress already. I start off with the good stuff. The good stuff to me is the pillow top itself. Then I go down to this part. I cut it. After that, I just start ripping it as I go. I get two a piece. I'm done with the mattress when it smells funny, or if I get down to where it's just the springs. I usually, when I crave to eat some mattress, it usually be after 2 o'clock after I eat. I'm urged, I need to urge, I gotta have it, gotta have it. For some reason, after sex, I would want some. The side effects of eating mattresses, just gas is really the only one you have. It enters my body and leaves my body. It goes through my system and goes out.
I'm very concerned about her health and like her digestive system, because I have seen it in the toilet. It comes out in whole pieces.
It was all the sponge that I was eating. I was like, it clogged up the toilet. Like, it's just sitting there.
If I was that desperate to get it out, I could take it and wash it, do everything I did to it, and I could use it again if I wanted, if I was that desperate. Ain't that strange.
I was sitting in the back seat, and it was like sponge down there. And I just picked it and took it and was like, just chewed on it. I've eaten couches, box springs, chairs, but for the last 10 years, mattresses has just been my thing. It's embarrassing. I couldn't just come out and be like, yo, I eat mattresses. Can't do that. It's not even all my family knows.
I fear that my sister could die from this.
The mattress goes down my throat. Sometimes it gets stuck. Like, I could choke and I could die.
God forbid that something would happen to her, because I would feel at fault for that.
Okay, it's bad for me, but I was eating when I was a kid, and now I'm an adult. I'm still eating it, and I'm still here.
Jennifer eating my mattress is getting way out of hand. We don't know what this mattress is doing to her. Me and my son just need to confront her today and ask her why she's doing it. It needs to stop.
So when you eat it, are you afraid of choking?
No.
Is that why you be like, all the time?
Yeah, when I be like, it shoot out of my throat like a cannon. I mean, I've been eating for 20 years, ain't nothing happened.
I didn't know you had been doing it for 20 years.
Blech.
Wow. And you don't think this hurting you? You don't worry about the chemicals that's in the match?
No, mattress. I don't.
This is full of chemicals.
How do you know what mattress is made of?
No,
right, but okay.
I'm not here to attack you. I'm just concerned, and I don't want anything to happen to you.
So if we go see a doctor, right, and they tell you that it's bad for you, are you gonna stop?
Once you're addicted to something, it's hard to stop.
I hope you try to not do it. Oh, please.
It's at the point where I don't care.
It's not who cares, because we obviously care about you.
Okay.
I ain't finna have a fight because you found out I eat mattress. Oh, well. Yeah, I gotta go.
If it's not what she wants to hear, she just gets up and usually leaves. We can lead her to the right way, but we can't make her choose the right path. She has to do that herself.
I'm going to the doctor today to get checked out because my mom and my brother was very concerned about what the mattress is doing to me when I consume it. I hate going to the doctor. Since you've been eating mattress for 20 years, I hope you don't tell me that this has been slowly killing you. I'm afraid.
So how often do you eat mattress foam?
I consume it every day. In like one sitting, like I would eat like about this thick. So,
okay.
And then it'd be like kind of big like that. Really only symptoms that I think is connected to it. I may be a little gassy, but then again, like I'm having sulfur burps.
Sulfur burps. Okay.
Yeah, like a fart in my mouth.
Okay. I'm very concerned about the foam. Mattress foam is not particularly digestible.
Wow.
Some of it may be forming a partial blockages in your small intestine so that food is not getting down effectively and it's fermenting and the gas is coming back up.
Wow, I never knew that.
Because it's indigestible, it could cause a blockage and a number of potentially deadly problems. How she's managed to do okay so far is a surprise. All right, well, the x-ray shows no definite obstruction, but it's hard for me to see what's called your stomach bubble.
All right.
Okay, sort of that suggests that maybe your stomach was full, and maybe it was full of foam mattress.
Yeah.
You know, the problem you face is you're gonna have a hole in your intestine or a complete bowel obstruction, and it's gonna be an emergency. And emergency means you could die.
Wow. Okay, got a little fear in my heart there. It just got serious.
You can change this.
I am gonna change this. I am gonna change this. Thank you.